UCL nurtures a really collaborative, multidisciplinary environment connecting engineers with medical scientists and people working in hospitals so that we can develop digital and medical technologies. We have that infrastructure in place and ready to go.
Obviously, we'd watched COVID-19 come across China, across the Middle East, and we watched it come up through Italy and Spain. So what was going to happen when it came to the UK? It wasn't going to be pretty. Now, you don't have to do intensive care for long before you find there are other methodologies for supporting these patients: high flow nasal oxygen, non-invasive ventilation, modalities like CPAP. And we just happened to have one in an anaesthetic museum cabinet that was in the corridor. So we picked it out, ran it down here to mechanical engineering, and Tim and the team took it to pieces and said, yes, we can do this, we can copy this, we can reverse engineer it, and we should be able to have you a prototype within 24 hours.
And the beauty of that device is it's very simple, it's purely mechanical, it's got no embedded electronics, so it meant that we would be able to hopefully manufacture it quickly. Because of the sheer volume of patients that would need treating with oxygen, that hospital oxygen supplies could be compromised. So we did a lot of design work to minimise how much oxygen one of these devices would use, and it was that design that went forward for mass manufacture.
I had contacts at the Mercedes Formula One team, made a couple of inquiries to see if they could get involved to help us. We got a message back saying, do not hesitate to call on the might of what we can do. We had half of a Formula One team to be able to help us with the design and manufacture.
What we managed to do working with Mercedes was go from a standing start to within 100 hours being back in the hospital with the first prototypes to test. Within 10 days of that first meeting, we received approval from the regulator in the UK, which defines whether a device is safe and effective to use on patients. And within 4 weeks, we had mass manufactured 10,000 of these devices at the Mercedes HPP Technology Centre in Brixworth.
With the CPAP ventilator on, it felt as if I was driving on the motorway in an open-top car. It's amazing the health engineering team at UCL work like this. They work with external organisations. However that support network comes together, however that collaboration works. And UCL does collaborate with a number of different organisations across hundreds, if not thousands, of research programmes. These are the sort of benefits we can see.
In response to the international need, we released all of our blueprints at zero cost so that they were free to download and manufacture in other countries. And we've supported the establishment of local manufacturing hubs in low and middle income countries across the world. UCL has really demonstrated how not only we can work so beautifully within the institution, but also how well we can work with other healthcare partners and industry partners to really deliver technologies which will make a difference to people's lives.